just, I think I want us to all stand up and hold hands for the beginning of it. That's just what I'm feeling right now.
My fairy is really happy right now.
Call in the directions. I'm going to set the space now. I've already done it remotely, but I'm going to do it again so that we're all on the same page. Okay? I want you to hear this and receive it. It's really important. Because if you know that you're protected, if you know that you are taken care of, that you're safe, that will allow you to go to the depths of the innermost subconscious aspects of your being, to the void, to the place that you don't want to see, you don't want to look at it, you're not interested. Some of us love the darkness. Some of us are frightened to our core of what's underneath or what's inside. Or we don't even know what's there, okay? Some of us have no idea what's down there. And this is where we get to take full responsibility for our internal void. And allow ourselves and embrace ourselves in this process to release that which no longer serves our highest and best expression, our divine mission, our divine purpose. Okay? This is serious work. This is not for the faint of heart. So if there's any resistance in you right now, I want you to address it. Because we haven't even started yet. And if there's resistance in your field right now, I want you to look it dead in the face. And I want you to address it. And I want you to look at it and say, no. I'm choosing to be here and I'm taking my power back. All right? So, I'm welcoming in and inviting in the presence and the power of Archangel Michael. Archangel Uriel. Archangel Gabriel. And Archangel Raphael. They are covering the four main directions of north, east, south, and west. I call upon Jesus, Buddha, Mother Mary, and Kuan Yin to hold up the pillars of these directions. In accordance with the cosmic sovereign law of one, I call upon all the archangels and ascended masters in accordance with this cosmic sovereign law of one to be fully present. I invite you here now. I invite the high councils of light, our galactic brothers and sisters that are in accordance with the law of one of the Emerald Covenant to be fully present now. I invite the legions of angels that walk with us on a daily basis, that are here to serve our highest and best expression, to be present with us now. I call upon the mighty I Am presence of each and every individual in this room and on this property to be fully, fully present in their bodies now for this experience. I call upon Ascended Master Saint Germain and Archangel Michael to create a pillar of light 12 miles down into the earth and 12 miles up into the cosmos in the center of this building. This pillar of light is serving as an escort for any energies that do not belong in our fields. Any energies that are imbalances that need to be released will go through this pillar of light and be escorted into the cosmic tube of light to be transmuted into divine light and love. Only divine love and light is welcome in this space, and we allow whatever is not serving us to be released. Is anyone not in agreement with this? Please speak now. Okay. So I'm sensing that there's one person in this room that is not in full yes. A full resonant yes at this moment. And I'm inviting you now to find that place within you that is not in a full resonant yes. It's just, if it's just nervousness or apprehension, I totally understand. It's very intense. I just invite you to check in now with your higher self, with your gut. And ask yourself if you're ready for this. If spirit brought you here, chances are you are. There are no mistakes. Take a deep breath in. Just so you know, I'm speaking an Andromedan language, so not to be afraid. I call upon White Buffalo Calf Woman. I call upon the spirit of Raven Medicine now. I call upon the Raven, the truth sayer, whose responsibility to spirit is to speak truth at whatever cost. Those who have raven medicine in this room know exactly what I'm talking about. I am embodying the raven priestess this evening, along with white buffalo calf woman. I speak Andromedan, and Chief Sitting Bull has a tendency to channel through me at times as well. So just to let you guys know that that is present. And now I request that we all come into a resonant ohm with each other. As we enter into the void, sending our roots down into Gaia. Spiraling down, not straight down, spiraling clockwise down into the earth, to the central crystalline core of Gaia. And when you get there, ask Gaia to connect you to the living organic network, so you are locked and loaded. You're ready to go. Asking Gaia to give you her energy to support you with this journey, with this process. Allowing that energy to fill you now. Rise up into your body, into the central column. Breathe it up into your central column, into your heart, allowing it to come into your heart and rest there for a moment. And on the exhale, allow your heart to expand out and connect to every single person in this room through your hands. As if a golden infinity spiral is traveling through your hands into your hearts and out the other side of your hands and into the next person. Creating this bond between us of light, of an infinite spiral of life. Unified, one being, one mind, one activity. Individualized in its expression and yet completely unified in its diversity. Now I want you to take it up and through the crown of your head and shoot it up through your branches, expanding and connecting into the central core of this galaxy, the galactic core, the zero point field within the center of this Milky Way galaxy. And then moving deeper into the realms of the center of this universe, the void. Tapping into the central heart of God, Goddess, the Divine Mother, the cosmic womb. And allow that energy to cascade down over you, drawing it in. The living organic network of life. Finding your tone, your soul tone now. Breathing in, inhaling, and allowing your voice to express your sound. The sound of you, of your individualized expression of the One. What does that feel like? Your bodies for a moment to find your resting place on the floor, to find your personal sovereign space for this event. If you can lay down, that's fabulous. If you need to sit, I understand. I would prefer your heads all be in towards the center. Sorry, I said that in the beginning, but maybe people weren't here. Head in, please. Represent the pillar of light in the center of your subconscious sphere. Of which you will be spending quite some time this evening. But just to know that it's there as a representation for you. It's a safe zone. Thank you. you to feel safe enough that if you need to cry, if you need to scream, if you need to ask for help to move energy, you're more than welcome to let loose here. You are safe. You are contained within an indigo sphere, a golden sphere, a rainbow sphere, impenetrable walls, spheres of light. Head in towards the center. Can you please turn and place your head towards the center? Thank you. We have 54, and me makes 55 individuals in this room right now. Individualized expressions of the one. That's a beautiful number. So I want to invite you. Some of us may be incredibly sensitive to other people's energies. And I want to invite you to stay focused on your own personal experience, okay? This is a very strong, energetic movement. And allow whatever is going on in the room, whether somebody is screaming, whatever it is, allow yourself to ride that wave of energy and move the energy through your body, not their energy, but your own energy. Okay? Does that make sense? So that you have the opportunity to experience the full expression of this movement. The full. And I would suggest that the liquids be taken out of this circle. Can someone? Yeah, thank you so much. Okay, any liquids nearby, of course, but out, I don't want to trip on the liquids. You can have anything closed liquid, fine, but the open liquids, thank you. Okay. In the center of the circle, I have Andara crystals. They are going to help facilitate this galactic mission that we're on here into the void. Up our subconscious mind, our astral energies, a wide spectrum of our environment. So now if you can take the tip of your thumb and your middle finger and put them together. Just feel the energy moving through your body in that way. as we go into the subconscious sphere room, the central room, you're going to be looking at 8 different doors. Each door represents a certain aspect of your life, a certain aspect of reality, if you will. And you'll be standing in the center in a pillar of light. Observing, deciding whether or not you want to go into each room. It's up to you. So we're just gonna let everybody else get settled. There's a few people still coming in. Get comfy. This is a long journey, but it's worth it. I was gifted a raven, a whole bird. And I was asked by this raven to use his wings. I had no idea what that meant until now. So we're in it together. Remembering that the pillar of light is in the center of the room. All your guides are here. Your I Am presence is here. The source beings are here. The source of your being is here. I invite you to be a little active now. I want you to breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. Breathe in through your mouth, out through your nose. This is called spiral breathing. In through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your mouth, out through your mouth, in through your mouth, out through your nose, in through your nose, out through your nose, in through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your mouth, out through your nose, in through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your mouth, out through your mouth, in through your mouth, out through your nose, in through your nose, out through your nose, in through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your mouth, out through your mouth, deeper in through your mouth, out through your nose, in through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your mouth, out through your nose, in through your nose, out through your nose, in through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your mouth, out through your nose, in through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your mouth, out through your mouth, and breathe normally. Feel the chi flowing through your body. Now we're moving into the infinite hara breathing. So as you inhale, we're going to go up and around behind you, up into your divine center above your head. And on the exhale, you're going to come down into your heart. And on the inhale, you're going to go behind you, down below into the earth chakra. And on the exhale, you're going to come up into your heart. So breathing in, behind you, up, and exhale down into your heart. Breathing in, down, around into your earth chakra, and up into your heart. Breathing up to your divine center, exhaling down into your heart. Breathing in, down into your earth chakra, exhaling into your heart. Breathing in and up, exhale down into your heart, and allow yourself to inhale down into the earth and up into your heart. Inhale up, down into your heart, inhale behind you, down into the earth, and exhale up. And center in the heart again, breathing in deeply, holding it, sniff, 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 hold it, and exhale. One more time, deep breath in, clearing all these vessels now, clearing, 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 releasing, clearing, breathing in again, hold it, breathe. Breathe, breathe, and exhale. Get that body moving. Start shaking your legs and your arms, moving the energy around. Cha, ha, 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 ha. We're on the ground. Let's move it. Let's move the energy. Yeah, move it. We haven't even gotten into the subconscious yet. Just remember that. All right. Move the energy. So the point of this is to move the energy out and into the central pillar of light and allow Archangel Michael to escort it out into the cosmic tube of light. to be transmuted into divine light and love now. We do not need this anymore. We are releasing it. We are saying, I release you with love and light.
I release you with love and light.
Yes. All right. Here we go. Shatter. Recognize and embrace that part of your power and wisdom that has not been freed into love. Shatter. Complete, unflinched piece, unfinished pieces of your soul. Polishing. Shatter. Initiators are lightning handlers, divine chaos attractors, whose sole purpose it is to shatter your inauthentic perceptions like a crystal glass, to shatter what defines your prison walls, shatter your romance with personal power. You who may think power has what your gnawing emptiness is actually craving, what your addictions are actually trying to fill. What are you afraid of in emptiness? Avoiding it by filling your mouth, your body, your life with more and more sophisticated ways to try not to face the initiator of change that is beckoning you to fusion like the divine siren song. Love wields the sword of truth, and in vibrational eloquence cuts away your narcissistic self. Absorption offering you entrance into the diamond body greenhouse acceleration chamber, whose specialty is blooming lotuses, you namely. Are you ready to take a journey there with me? To that quantum leap hothouse. The Raven Priestess House. If so, come with me now down this corridor. Thank you. notice first that you find yourself in a stunningly beautiful temple room with night sky for walls and a floating golden dais on which Isis is seated with her arms across her chest in the mudra signifying the true power held in surrender. There's a huge golden brazier burning with purple magenta flames in the center of this initiatory chamber. Presently, a purple-robed priestess beckons you, follow her. You notice that as you move along the hall you have entered, geometric patterns and sounds are ignited on the walls and floor in response to your frequency as you pass by. Like a sheet of dry ice, mist shot with brilliant colored lasers through them. As you come to a gold door, she offers you a mudra of recognition of your essence. Sound your signature sound, marks your head with a lightning bolt of gold dust, and sends purple corridors of light from her eyes upon which you climb and ride into the current that carries you into a white marble hall with purple sugilite pillars. Once inside, you see crystals of every imaginable color and size. Across the chamber is a shimmering gold presence, which you now recognize as the initiator. Be it Isis, the Divine Mother, the Raven Priestess, whoever is there is for you. Without hesitation, you move toward it. You see eyes burning holes through the veils within with their clarity, eyes that see you totally clearly and call you to surrender even more deeply. Allow the eyes of Isis to become gold corridors of light, currents upon which you travel into communion with truth. Loosen your reality coordinates. Isis telepathically makes you aware that initiation requires a risk, a challenge, for you can't possibly know the outcome, or it would not be initiation. She informs you that this initiation is just a preparation for the initiation that your life will provide for you. She asks you if it is your will to fully surrender in this chamber where she is not ensnared by your perceived limitations, your desired outcomes, your unending storylines, your entangled justifications. Because she sees beyond them. If you say yes, she offers you the power to break the belief that you do not have the power to change virtually anything in your experience. Allow the eyes of Isis to challenge you to break through to vibrational alignment, to clarity, simply through remaining with her unflinchingly sphinx-like gaze of truth. You now apprehend why Isis is called in the archetypal realms the pruner. In timelessness, she ripens your potential to realize yourself through merciless confrontation of your lies, your reactions, your power trips, your need for approval and recognition that unsuccessfully tries to hide the real perpetrator, your reactive nature in the cosmic laundry hamper, hoping that little bad smell won't be noticed over eons. Isis now asks you to open the hamper, to break through, to confront your reactions, to be willing to go on the adventure of growth wherever it is calling you, no matter how scary that looks. Until the recognition of the face you had before you were born shines back in the soul's black scrying bowl. What in your ego's distortion are you willing to offer to be consumed in these purple flames in the brazier in the temple of the Divine Mother? For it is I, Isis, whom you have called into your life on the bullet train of consciousness to co-star in your movie, to lovingly shatter the hall of mirrors you so carefully constructed. Shatter quickly like a crystal ball, bursting all at once in all directions across time and space. Shatter who you think you are, first farming out in a hologram of simultaneity, cosmic jellyfish tentacled lives going in all directions in time and space, then reversing the hologram. She calls back your lives and dimensional expressions, hurling to a point of singularity, a point converging into one omega flashpoint life, such as this life could be, shattering you into union. Isis, now reflect what you, who you presently are defining yourself to be with such clarity that you finally perceive yourself as you actually are. Reactivity is one way to learn, but slow, repetitive, and oh so painful. This endemic of surrender is quick. Look out from my eyes at your mind's distortions, your life's lies about your willful intent to get what you think you want without surrendering to the divine within. Shatter those perceptions. Shatter the stranglehold of being, quote unquote, special, needing to be recognized or approved of as something, somebody. Shatter any blind bondage to personal power. Release the strings of the tired and tattered looking puppet of trying to control in your ego. Shatter them. They are no use. There are boondoggles encompassing lifetimes in the initiation chambers of Earth. Allow the electronic substance of your human makeup to shatter in the intensity of the purple flames birthing the white lotus from your muddy depths. Offer gratitude as you are now in these contractions of second birth. Amidst currents of jagged purple fuchsia magenta coursing through your energy bodies in the surrender that allows you to melt like spring snow in the sun's fiercely tender caress, taking with it and its solar flare contractions your grasping ego. Let go. Trust. Viscerally feel that it is I, Isis, the Divine Mother, the Initiator, here in the emptiness with nurturing sky arms. Offer up your craving to try to fill the empty place that is actually the temple of my chalice, ready to conceive in your heart the newborn Horus of Nuit and Hadit. Fecund in night, united with the fire that is the core of every star. The flame that burns at the center of all life. I, Isis, and the Lord of the Aeon, call into existence from the palpable pulse of our sacred passion, you, the blue holy child, who is archetypally born of the lovers who live within you as the fusion of love and power. Rose and sandalwood lovingly anointing the body of the one. Gently stroking the place in you that fears that it can be separate. Into remembrance of the sparkling electronic grid of my crystalline chalice that provides whatever initiatory container you genuinely require at this moment to further empty your chalice and entrust. Step out of structure, step out of mind, step out of power that futilely binds. Allow me now place on your head the clarifying seven-pointed diamond star, scintillating in the gold dust crown of the 13 moons bearing witness to conjunctio, the union of all opposites. Dualities. This is the moment the snake oracle predicted in its ascent up the tree of life. When the two sacred snakes undulate in union in the heart of Tippereth, then shall the eagle and the lioness merge to create the divine fool child who quantum leaps off the edge of known reality. And in radical trust and in full remembrance of its origins and union, surrenders laughingly to the purple flames of transmutation, an empty chalice of second birth and the fusion of union. Be received now and in adoration's tearful embrace. Welcome yourself home, beloved. Receive yourself now as pellucid awareness, allowing maximum passage of light without obstruction or distortion, pellucid awareness. Experience yourself in this moment as pellucid awareness. Unobstructed awareness, open awareness, luminous awareness, empty awareness. And in that open, luminous, empty awareness, you are a powerful agent of planetary awakening within the dream. Shrill cry of Hawk says, awaken, initiate. Awaken as pellucid awareness within this dream. As you stand in the center of this initiatory chamber, subconscious sphere of your consciousness, You stand in a pillar of light. You notice that in every direction, there's a door. There's a room that beckons you. Where will you go first? Are you ready to see what lives inside these rooms? Some of them are very simple. Some of them, not so much. Let's start with relationships, shall we? So northwest, the door begins to crack and open. You decide whether or not you want to cross the threshold of this room. Are you ready to look at your relationships? All of them, including your relationship with yourself. So let's start there, shall we? As the door opens for you, it beckons you in. What do you see? Can you extend your pillar of light into this room to light up the darkness? Of the darkest dark of your heart within this room. What do you see? Are there luggage trunks? Old relationships with past lovers, friends, parents? What does it look like? Does it feel messy and cluttery? Does it feel crystalline in nature? What kind of work is there for you to do? Really just take a moment and allow yourself to be rigorously honest with what's going on there. How are you treating others? What is the quality of the air in that room? Does it feel stifling? Does it feel thick? What does it feel like? What about your siblings? Do you see them there? Right now, I want you to put your hand on your heart. Place your hand on your heart now. With all the energy you can muster in this moment, I forgive myself for all the times I abandoned myself in all of my relationships. I forgive myself. For all the times I abandoned myself in relationships. I forgive myself. Really feel this, okay? Just drop in. For all the times I abandoned myself in relationships, ride that wave of energy. Release, release. Let it go. Forgive yourself. I forgive myself for all the times I abandoned myself in relationships. Feel that. Feel your heart. Let yourself feel that and release it. It can be taken up into the tube of light. You do not have to hold it anymore. It is time to let it go. Let it go. And I want you to look at all the trash, all the luggage, and I want you to start throwing it up into the tube of light right now. With your hands, throw it. Let it go, move it through, just get rid of it. I release you with love and light. You are no longer welcome here. I release you with love and light. One more time. I release you with love and light. You are no longer welcome here.
I release you with love and light. You are no longer welcome.
I command. Okay, let's try that again, shall we? I command.
I command.
All of my vital life force energy.
All of my
to be returned to me now. Cleaned. Cleared. Healed. And detoxified. And in the present moment now. I ask for this healing. From beyond the moment of self. To below the center of the earth. From beyond the pure light above creation. To below the well of life. And the fire of life. At the center of the earth. And all other planets, and beyond, and between all of these. I ask for this healing through all bodies, all levels, all lifetimes on Earth, and all other planets, galaxies, universes, and dimensions back to the point of creation. Returning me to my original divine blueprint now. Restore me to my original innocence. Heal all the damage. And bring this healing into the present now. It is done. Okay, that was the first one. I want you to look around that room right now. And I want you to see what's left. What do you see? I want you to place golden pink ray, the golden pink ray of divine love, on the floor of that room. I want you to just wash it clean. The walls, the ceiling, the floor, with divine love. Knowing that the ancient sisterhood of the golden rose is fully present and alive and aware and awake in all of us. Giving us this opportunity now, they are here with us. Kuan Yin, Mother Mary, Mary Magdalene, they're all here working with us with the golden pink ray of divine love. In our relationships, bringing harmony and balance in all of our relationships. So right now, I want you to command that in your life from this moment forward. From this moment forward, I command harmony and grace in all of my relationships, including myself. Going deeper now. Shall we move on? If so, say yes. Okay, that was room one. We have seven more to go. But let me tell you, we're gonna get through this together. And it's worth it. I think we're gonna go into the Northeast now, into creativity. This is a place, this is a room. And this room is filled with pixie dust and fairies and beautiful expressions of spirals. But then there's also the black sludge. The place where you get writer's block. the resistance, the pain, where you don't speak your truth. Right? Let's go there. Hand on your heart. I forgive myself for all the times I did not speak my truth. I forgive myself for all the times I did not speak my truth. I forgive myself for all the times I did not speak my truth. The raven has joined us now. I have in my hands raven talons that I cut myself off of the bird I was gifted. We are slicing through each and every illusion. Each and every illusion that tells us that we don't have the right to shine, to create, to express. Enough already. Enough. Into the cosmic tube of light to be transmuted into divine light and love now!
Thank you.
choosing now to step out of the karmic cycle. This is not our choice. This is a program running. If you disagree, that's okay. If you agree, that's okay. Whatever your choice and your sovereignty is, it's yours!
Creativity room now. What do you see? What do you see now, huh? Just kidding. Okay. The Raven Princess speaks. Okay. This is a fully conscious ceremony. We cannot check out here. It's not an option. It's just not an option. Did you hear us out there? Okay. Okay. Oh, wow. Okay. Moving into the East Room. The Room of the Inner Child. This one is pretty interesting for most. The center of our core beingness now, the inner child, the child within you that screams in pain when they're not heard, when she or he is not heard or acknowledged or taken into consideration, that inner child. We're going to talk to them now. We are going to give them the opportunity to be heard for real. This is where your identity exists in this room. So look around. What do you see about yourself in here? What about your identity do you want to pluck out and get rid of? What about your ego are you willing to release, to let go? This is the deeper level of unconscious work, the childhood traumas, you know? This is the part of the work that nobody wants to do. But we're here now. We're laying on the ground. We're going to do this shit. We're going to make it happen. Excuse my French. We're going to do it. Because we have the support of the Divine Mother. We have the support of all the ancient sisterhood. And we have the support of your higher self right here, right now, to do this work. To recognize what doesn't serve any longer. Where in your childhood did you go in your childhood? Where did you escape to? When you didn't feel safe? Where did you go when you disassociated and checked out? This is where we want to go. We want to bring you back from that place where you went to, where you left your body. No more. Can we say no more? No more. I am fully embodied here and now. For the benefit of all beings, I came here. Enough is enough. I am here now, and I am willing to listen to my inner child and his or her needs. Because all my needs are met always, in all ways. Always, always, always. And that's the only time I ever use that word, always, is right now. All my needs are met, always. All my needs are met, always. I'm gonna take it up a notch. Child now. What is it that you want to hear come from her mouth, from his mouth? Where are the wounds? And are you willing to let them go? All the times that your dad told you that you will be seen and not heard. All the times that your mother smacked you across the arm or pinched you when you were asking for your needs to be met. All the times you were ignored or neglected. Your inner child just let it go now. Feel that. Feel the pain. once and for all, just feel it and let it go, beloved. Let it go. Just let it go. And speak now. Speak your truth. Say whatever you want to say to whoever. Whoever you want to say it to, let it out. Do it. That's right. We are enough.
I am good enough!
Yes!
I am enough for myself.
Who do you need to forgive right now? Whose face is in that room with you? Look at them square in the face. Look at them and tell them you will no longer tolerate anything that is not in alignment with the highest truth. Aho. I honor you.
I will no longer tolerate what is not in my highest current truth!
Yes. I live my truth.
I live my truth.
I speak my truth.
I speak my truth.
I am my truth.
I live my truth.
I live my truth.
I release you with love and light.
I release you with love and light.
Please forgive me. Please forgive me. For I did not know my truth. In order to express it, please return your energy back to you now. I release your energy to you. It is yours and yours alone. And I command my energy to be returned to me now. I release all cords and ties that do not serve my highest good. All circuitries that do not serve my highest good are released here and now.
Feel the resonance.
energy, Spirit, as it cleanses you from all the dross, the weight, the burden that you've been carrying since you were a child. Thank you.
go. Whatever's left, just let it go. This is the final run of this energy being released. You are responsible for your energy body. Is that clear?
Yes.
If it hasn't been before this, it is now. Knowing the truth of who you are as a divine being, living a human experience. All aspects of yourself, whether it be raven, pixie, mermaid, fairy, elf, gnome, dragon,
peacock,
phoenix, peacock, whatever it is, crow, owl, eagle, jaguar, all that shit, own it. Settling in to the pillar of light within your subconscious sphere, stepping out of the room of your inner child in the east. How are you guys doing?
Okay.
Do you want to keep going?
Yes.
Okay, we've been in this for an hour and a half, almost 2 hours, but we're gonna keep going, aren't we? Whoever's in it is in it. Am I right? All right, let's keep going. Sometimes these can be 4 hours, whatever, it happens. Okay, this is a lot of work at all in one night. This is like doing years of work in one ceremony, so just understand that. Okay. Holy mackerel. Okay, so my intuition is saying not to do certain rooms tonight because of the festival. So these other rooms I'm going to share with you for you to work on your own in your own private space, in your own sacred space, because the energies that exist within these rooms are not for everyone else. They're only for you. Okay? And it's incredibly important to honor and respect the individual sovereignty of each and every individual in this room. And therefore, I invite you to do this stuff on your own. Okay? Because some of this stuff is pretty malevolent. Okay? Some of it is pretty gnarly. And we are here to take back our power, to be fully sovereign, to live fully embodied on this planet, to express our divine nature, and to fulfill our divine mission, whatever that is. And you know what that is, or you wouldn't be in this room right now. So. The West Room of wealth and abundance. I'm gonna say what they are, and we're gonna choose the next one together. We're gonna take a vote, sort of. Southwest, temporal body, your timeline body, the temporal mesh, the time-space continuum within your energy body and your physical body. Okay? South, access to the unconscious, where your librarian lives. I'm not sure we should do that one tonight, because that's where the malevolent librarian tends to be. So I'm not sure we want to go there right now. Southeast, astral experiences, stored traumas. Personalities. That one's a heavy duty room. And then we have North, health. So, say yes to these, each one, if you want to do them. Okay? And based on how strong the yes is, I will determine the next one that we do. West, wealth and abundance.
Yes!
Yes!
North, health.
Yes!
Southwest, temporal body.
Yes!
Okay, there was a few for that one. South, access to the unconscious.
Yes!
Oh, geez. Southeast, astral experiences.
Yes!
Okay, well, let's see. You said yes to all of them. No, I'm not gonna limit this in any way, but okay. The thing is, I want you to go in. I'm gonna go within your embodiment now, and I want you to really tune in and ask your higher self what it is that you need in this moment to complete this ceremony before we rebirth, which we've already been doing for the last hour and a half, but before we go into the next phase of rebirth, which is the last room. Scream it out. Wait, not the directions, I won't remember. Okay. Okay, I hear wealth and abundance and health.
Librarian.
Oh, librarian. Oh, geez. All right, this is what we're gonna do. I gotta finish it. Woo! Okay, can I just go to the bathroom? We'll take a 5-minute break.
next day. You guys ready for the second phase?
Yes.
You know, a lot of screaming, a lot of releasing. Deep breath. Let's come into our bodies again. Centering into the center of stillness within. That golden sphere of light. Do you remember the golden sphere of light from the beginning? I want you to reconnect now with your golden sphere of light. Expanding on the exhales into your field. We're going to reestablish this field again. The south. There's a door beckoning you. You're standing in your pillar of light in your subconscious sphere temple. As you walk towards this door, it opens. You step over the threshold, not knowing what to expect. Stepping deeper and deeper into your unconscious mind. into the place that you rarely access. It's pretty dark in there. Responsible for our sovereignty, are we not? So as we step down into this library of the unconscious, what do we see? Every step. Is there a light guiding your way? Is there a ball of light showing you the way down? Or are you stepping down into the blackness of night? Where is your beacon guiding you? Where does it want you to go? Do you have a guide? Someone that is there for you, not necessarily in human form. Beckoning you to look at. What do you see? How many layers deep are you willing to go? How deep is the pain lies within the unconscious? Breathe into the pain. If you find it, breathe it in. Take it on. Do not hesitate for 1 second to feel your pain. Freedom comes in the release. Doing the work. I know that you're tired. You've been doing this for a long, long, long time. That you've been here over and over and over again. And my heart knows your pain. We all know your pain. Do you want to hold that pain anymore? What do you want to do? This is your choice now. This is your opportunity to let go.
pay attention to who is in that room with you. Who do you see? Are they from this life? Where are they from? Are they part of you? Or are they actually not part of you? Is this of your own making, this pain? Or is this something that you chose to take on for others as a bodhisattva? Be very clear what your motivations have been up until this point. Because now is the time to choose again. To choose to live once again. To choose life again. To choose to be fully embodied with your divine human nature intact. No questions asked. Life is meant to be lived. Do you see anything? Ha ha! Chai! Shimon, show ho! Show! Ha! I'm feeling the release of malevolent energies in the field right now. I'm feeling the deliberate interference. I'm feeling the resistance within some of us to really own our stuff, to own who and what we are and what we have created on this planet, and being willing to take responsibility for what we have done. Whether it be in this lifetime or another, there is no past, present, or future. It is all right now. Right here. Right now. Hand on your heart. Left hand on your heart. I forgive myself for all the times I judged myself as not enough. I forgive myself for all the times I judged myself as not enough. Once more. I forgive myself for all the times I judge myself as not enough. I choose now to take back my power. I choose now to retrieve all aspects of myself. Retrieving my soul from all places and time.
Retrieving my soul from all places and time.
where I may have left a fragment of myself. Through the process of trauma, I command all of my vital life force energy now.
I command all of my vital life force energy now.
To be returned to me now. Cleaned, cleared, healed, and detoxified. And in the present moment, I am fully embodied.
I am restored
to my original divine blueprint now. Anything that is not of the highest light
is not welcome.
In my personal energetic matrix,
in my subconscious sphere.
Ho. Where do you want to go from here? What do you want to see? What are you choosing to create? Deep in the depths of your unconscious mind, the collective unconscious. Everyone is. So we are going to come back into our bodies now. And begin to rest. Stepping out of the unconscious room back into the pillar of light within the center of your subconscious sphere now. After me, I call upon my medical assistance team to shower my entire energetic matrix with golden light.
chamanakai, sha, ha! Sha! Each and every individual in this room, right here, right now, step in. I command you to be fully present in your body right now. Get present. Thank you. Thank you. Take a deep breath. I honor the divinity within each and every one of you. This is deep, deep work. This is not a joke. Thank you for showing up tonight. Thank you for honoring who you are. On such a deep level that you heard the call and you showed up for it. Bless you. The Divine Mother is deeply grateful for your presence here on this planet. Continuing to move the energy quietly through your body. Let it release, let it go into the tube of light. Take you back to source. So again, stepping into the pillar of light. Center of stillness within.
golden sphere of light. It's your go-to, always. Expansion of consciousness, grounding, whatever it is that you need, it's right there. It's where everything is absolutely perfect. In its stillness, in its movement. There is nothing that exists within this space that is not of your highest good. Divine and perfect order exists here. So from that place, I want you to extend your energy up through your branches again, connecting into the galactic core, to the zero point field. Reaching and extending up past the galactic core into the cosmic ocean of light, the central heart of God, Goddess, all it is. Find your soul star. Look around and see your 144 pointed soul star tetrahedron that's swimming around in the ocean of light. And just spend some time there in that flawless, effortless space of pure light. Listening gold, white light. And as you enter your soul star, you activate your source code. You watch them light up. Spark. As this glistening star tetrahedron travels down your tube of light into your crown, you allow your source codes and your soul star to enter your body now in perfect health, in full embodiment, multidimensionally present, clear, crystal clear.
extremity. Reach your hands over your head and stretch your legs out. Stretch your entire body from head to toe. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Feel the chi flowing through your body. Stretch. Breathe into your body. I am in my body now. I am fully present. Roll to the right side or left side, whichever works, and lay there for a moment, holding yourself and your inner child, thanking your inner child for all the work that he or she did tonight. Thanking your spirit for bringing you here tonight. Take your time, facing the center. I'd like everybody in the circle together, please. Come over here to the center of the circle. We all sit and hold hands. Yes, please. Yes, please. Holding this space with me tonight. Thank you so much for being here. We have some people come in. I need to hold a hand. Each and every master soul in this room. Thank you for showing up. Thank you for showing up for your divine appointment today, tonight, this weekend, this lifetime, all of those lifetimes that we looked at tonight. Thank you. We honor you so completely for being here, embodied in human form. White Buffalo Calf Woman would like to say something. This is for you. Shoma Chanamaka. Shomo Chomana Chanamaka. Shoma Cho. Shomana Chanamaka. Shomo Konamaka. Shomo Chanamaka. Chanamakanamok. Oh, Shama. Shamaka. Shomana Chonamoka. Shamaka. Shamaka. So deeply for being on this planet at this time. This world is in trouble. We beg of you, we ask you to please. Into the world. Take this love into the world and share it with all you see. This love that is only yours and yet it is everyone's. There is only one love. Whether it shows up in the form of a raven, or a little girl walking down the street. There is only one love. There is only one of us here. Entering in your heart, breathing in golden light, allowing the golden spiral, infinite spiral of light to run through your heart, into your hands, into the next person, bonding the circle together. I'd like to thank all of our legions of source beings, of angels, of guides, of our mighty I Am presences. I'd like to thank the Raven, White Buffalo Calf Woman, Chief Sitting Bull, Archangel Michael, Archangel Uriel, Archangel Gabriel, and Archangel Raphael, Jesus, Buddha, Mother Mary, Kuan Yin, the ancient sisterhood, Mother Mary, Mother Teresa, Mary Magdalene, Kuan Yin, Lady Nada, Isis.
others that have come before us, our ancestors and our future generations. The work that we did tonight affects us all. Throughout time and space, through all dimensions, this carries a ripple like no other. I invite you to continue this process in your own private space in the weeks to come as you begin to release and slough off all the weight and the burden of all the lifetimes on this planet and all others. I encourage you to continue to do this work, to explore and go deeper. Do not stop here. I ask Archangel Michael now to close and seal this sphere with golden light, this portal of light to be completely closed and sealed down to the size of the head of a pin. Zoop! Closed and sealed. Back in our bodies, right here, right now. Ending with three ohms, together unified. Giggles are good. Can we just laugh?
In my mind that I'm a priestess. Just so you know.
Oh.